So the brand is Ace Magician, though they're all probably pretty similar. And on the back, all you have is this here. Get the sun, get the light out of it. You know, 16 RAM, a 512 SSD, or a ROM as they call it. It has a Ryzen 7 5800U, I think. It hopefully will say it in here. I'm not familiar with the AMD CPU side at all, unless you're talking about maybe the early 2000s when they were killer. And I bought a bunch of the, I think it was Opterons, and just a time when they were doing good. So I don't know a lot about this at all. Supposedly, now this is pretty quick. I mean, I guess I'll test it. They say that this thing here can run triple 4K monitors. Come on. That can't be true, can it? I mean, that's just ridiculous. What I'd really like to test and find super funny, and I do plan to do, I'm going to do a full benchmark of my full gaming PC. It isn't that current. It's like at least 2 years old technology. So this isn't any top benchmark. Just my very solid gaming PC. I only play Team Fortress 2, and that's a 10-year-old game, which works fine on this. I have the Intel i7-12700K, and memory 32 gig, of course. Graphics is a GeForce RTX 2060. It has, I'm trying to remember, honestly, 6 gigabytes of onboard RAM on the graphics card. But anyway, this isn't about my PC. This is about this thing. But that gives you an idea. So I'm going to just do some apples to apples benchmark and see how close this mini gets. I think there's no way that this can out benchmark my huge tall tower gaming PC, man. There's no way. Oh, that's why I got this, because it's so beautiful. It's kind of stupid, but if you have to choose between all the generic brands, you see a design you like, hey, pick that brand, right? During the system boot process, if you cannot log into your personal account, turn off Wi-Fi and LAN, skip the option, then log into your personal account. I'll leave that there, not even sure what that's about. This one is going to be getting a fresh Ubuntu Linux, the primary OS I work on at work. This will also take the place of my house security system. I won't go into that in too much detail because that's my personal business. All right, so we got the AMD Radeon and a 7 with a 5800, they said. And I really want to show you the ports on each end. So first we'll start with this. So you got your power, of course, on the left. This is a lock, like a Kensington lock. You have a cable and a key, and it's like to tie things to a table so nobody can steal it. So that's a nice little touch there. Dual LAN RJ45, display and HDMI, reverse. Two 2.0 USBs. You go, what? That's weak. Bing! Two 3.0. This is the front, right? The back is, you know, you want to throw a little old mouse and keyboard on that. You don't care about speed. Your front one's major. Plus a nice charging port to pop in your phone, little mic port, and audio port. You could even headphone this bad boy. So anyway, I hope you enjoy figuring out how the heck this is going to work. And we'll have fun doing it. All right, so where are we going to put it? We got my two main monitors for my gaming PC over here. I did want this one on a stand just to kind of mix things up. And... you know, not have so much junk way up high over here. I just wanted a more personal, separate thing here. So that's why I didn't use a wall mount for this thing. It's just a regular mount. So I'm going to, it's something that I guess I misunderstood. But this particular computer says, you know, VESA mount available. That's true. It's a bracket. But it's going to take the bracket and you couldn't use your stand. The picture, which is fair enough, you know, it just shows monitors which have a stand down here, like most do. And you have a VESA available, but just to know, if you're using the VESA for a wall mount or a desk mount, you can't attach your PC that we saw over here to it, because there's only one VESA setup available on the back of a monitor. Just wanted to show you how the VESA would work if you did want to do it. You have your little screws. I would think that they included them, but I cannot see them. It might just be a standard. Oh, they actually say M3, but it's weird. I don't think they include a screw. And this is the power block. Look at that super small power block. That's killer. And you got power cord, of course, and an HDMI. I already have a good one of those. Let me make sure. I take that back. Peel up this, and what do you see? A mini, dude, that's hard. You know, you could miss that easy. So here are the screws we talked about. So you will have screws here if you want to find some way to mount it. And even on a wall, on screws, whatever. That's just a normal, you know, thing. It'll go downwards. But yeah, that's how the VESA mount will work. This is actually for SATA. I just realized that because I haven't looked at it yet. This is not a PC riser. This is a SATA with power and SATA cable for a disk. So this is going to allow us to prop. I haven't read the directions, let's be straight, but probably pop this in to the circuit board right there with the gold terminals and have it freaking activate. And all of a sudden you have a place for this. I wonder if, I don't think there's an external, no, like a little slot for like pop it in, take off your disc, and you know, pop it out. Nah. All right, so that's everything that's in the box. Let me make sure there's nothing under this flap. Everything whatsoever we have looked at. Oh yeah, any of you old guys remember the Ataris? I do restore those. Catch me on eBay. All right, I am doing a boot. I just turned it on, and remember that I do want to show you the boot. This is the first boot ever on the PC back there. If this has Windows, I'm just going to forget it because I'm not even putting Windows on it. I'm just going to show you what you would get if you turn it on and do nothing. Yeah, I figured it probably comes with Windows. Hopefully I get some activation key, like if I ever want it or need it. No, I don't want to switch all that. I was thinking about making my main PC Ubuntu Linux and keeping this Windows, but nah. This one is my Linux box. So it's still trying to boot. Of course, the first boot's going to take quite a while. I haven't interrupted the video yet. So we'll see how long it takes. Let me get you set down here on the tripod for a minute. And here we go. All right, I mean, I'll click a couple things. It doesn't matter. Yes, I'm in America, United States, yes. US, good enough, keyboard, yep. No second keyboard layout. All right, if you really need help getting started, what I'm doing here is creating an Ubuntu boot, live boot USB. So I plugged in a USB I want to use. I installed a program called Rufus on Windows. It's simple, it makes USBs. And then I went to the Ubuntu website and just downloaded a desktop image. The desktop allows the try also, stuff like that. I just choose a desktop because this is not a server. And you just get it on that page, and then we're going to create it using the thing we downloaded with this Rufus tool. All right, so I'm going to find my, which is here, my USB. I'll do an ISO image. I'm going to select it from desktop where I downloaded it right there. And format, I'm going to leave all default. Let me see, MBR, yeah. Well, I'm going to actually use GPT, the modern version. MBR is the old version, old-fashioned version. And yeah, I'll use UEFI, just normal current stuff. It doesn't do anything there. Add fixes, don't need that. Volume label is fine. I think that should all be fine right there. So all you do is click start. And I want it in ISO mode, not a disk dump, which will copy just the file. You'd have a .iso on your USB, which wouldn't do proper. This tool expands that, unzips it, uncompresses it, etc., and fills it like it's a CD, for example, with Ubuntu installer on it. Of course, that's only for the people that really aren't techie. That's why I'm going into this deep detail. All right. So we'll be back in a bit. It's trying to create this USB now. All right, so this is supposed to be done. So I'm just gonna plug it right into the front of this PC, and I'm gonna reboot the PC. I'm gonna just hold this down. and then turn it on and see if it works, or else, you know, I'll have to start figuring things out, looking at BIOS. But let me see if this will boot straight to that USB if I get super lucky. I doubt it. I should have done a boot options here. It's probably trying to load Windows again. So I was having trouble getting into, first off, it won't boot off USB as we saw. It keeps going to Windows. Took me a while to get into BIOS. I had to let it power off and settle, then do the normal delete or the escape real quick, and I finally was able to get into BIOS just to see if it even detects my USB, see if I want to do anything else. That's fine. Power, I probably want to change. No, not this particular power. It's fine. I won't touch any of that crap. USBs could be important. Legacy is, yeah, everything enabled. Sweet. It sees the PONY or PNY brand right there. Awesome. We're on the right track. Network stack, I'll keep that off. I don't need to image this machine or anything. NVR, this it, not NVR, that's my related to my job. NVM disk, it's an air disk, like the brand, probably some cheap crap, but you know, that's why this is just a play machine in case something happens. You do always have that little SATA adapter too, to put in a better disk for sure, build an OS on it later maybe. That's something else you might think about. Well, the Pixie, I don't really need that. I'm gonna turn that off. I do not want it booting from the network or anything, so I'm gonna turn that off. Not that it would, but just saying. AMD, and I'm not familiar with this AMD crap. I'm certainly not gonna change any of the CPU settings. We see that, driver health. Security is fine, there's the disks. Boot, I'm gonna probably try, let's see, fix boot order. Here we go, boot overrides. And we're gonna boot and see if we can get into this freaking Ubuntu USB operating system, that tiny little operating system coming up here. Then I'll have to look at some disk things, figure out how to clear out the whole disk, do an install, and we can look at some of the install screens too if you want. Well, I know only some of you will be interested in Ubuntu installs. Oh no, I hope this freaking works right. I know Windows, I don't want Windows to, here we go, USB. Something didn't work on that. I had chose it. This may not be bootable. I may have to, you know, work on the USB a bit more. I just told it, yes. Try or install Ubuntu. Now this is something I do almost every day at work for the last few years. So we're not going to go into super detail. If you can get this far, then you'll be able to finish the whole project, because it took, you know, a little bit of skill to build all that and whatever. If you have some kind of tech ability, this is fine. So all you're going to do, it's going to pop up a try or install. And I'm going to do an install. So I'll show you. Maybe it'll only take a minute or two. I'm actually interested to see what the disk layout looks like when I get here. So I'm going to go with normal apps. Yeah, I don't care. I'll install some third-party crap if I need to. It doesn't matter to me. Next. All right. That's cool. It's actually telling you you can keep Windows if you want. I do not want that. But look at that, that's pretty cool. Install Ubuntu with Windows Boot Manager. Then you could have both. That's probably what most people would like. But because I already have other machines, I want to choose erase and install completely. Write the changes. I'm prepared to do it. Let's go. Woo. All right. Region, New York is fine, Eastern. And let me get this done here. All right, just entered the usernames, passwords. Almost finished copying files already. See how quick that is? All right, installation's complete. Restart, and it probably have me remove the USB, or else I'll do that now. There it is. I thought so. Remove the installation medium, and press enter. We're now booting up on Ubuntu. Not gonna get into any Ubuntu deal on this thing. That's a whole nother 20 videos if we were going to do anything like that. So that should get you there to install an Ubuntu onto the mini PC. Let me just make sure that it does boot correctly. show you. And we're going to finish with the benchmarks, the really cool stuff you wanted to do. So we'll go here. Go here. Enter. And we're on Jimmy Jam Jellyfish. Jimmy Jam Jellyfish. I'm not going to connect those now. I can do that anytime. Skip for now. Skip for now. No, don't send info. I do this screens every day. Done, and we're done. Now, there's a tons of stuff I have to do on this. Install Chrome for starters, not Firefox. Just personal stuff I'm used to. Clean up everything, customize it. But that's it. I am going to try and install a benchmark on both machines here. And let's see how close this mini tiny PC that's cheap can get to my full gaming PC. Haven't even really showed you. There's not much to see, honestly. Ooh, I want to vacuum that today. But, you know, I don't do a lot of LEDs or anything. It's just your basic PC. 2 or a 4 terabyte SSD for storage. Just some nicer stuff. But the video and the CPU is pretty old. 2 years old, at least. All right, guys. So I finally managed to find a benchmark that you can run on both Windows and Linux. Matching, of course, it's not apples to apples, obviously. It's a completely different OS. But I just want to get an idea. How close does this tiny PC come to this expensive gaming PC? Originally about $3,000. Now it's probably worth not much at all. All right, guys, I'm back just to check in. I've been kind of coming back and forth to this as I have time. Had a lot of problems trying to figure out a compatible benchmark between both sides. After doing all the Cyberpunk 7.7 testing, I determined that you can't install that on Linux. So I found one of my games in my list, BioShock Infinite. I can't install on both because I want to get a somewhat similar apples to apples. So I am going to run these two after they're installed on each machine, and we should get final definitive results on if my big gaming PC is more powerful and can produce more frame rates than this mini PC. I am sure it can, so the results will be interesting. Hey guys, I finally have the results. One last clip here. What we have is the mini PC over here on the one piece image, and then you have the gaming PC, my good PC, on the right. So if we start with the high quality, we'll go over here. High was 49.67 benchmark BioShock. They were all at 1080p resolution, and I have high, very high, and ultra. So you can see the PC on the same test for test, 49 versus 306, very huge. And jump down here to the very high, which is 4950, and the very high here on the gaming PC, 306. They're all pretty much the same. You can see 306s, 306s, 49s, 49s. It's basically the same. So that is how much difference you have between the mini PC, which is great for everything except gaming, and I didn't buy it for that either, so that doesn't even matter. I'm just happy to use it as a Linux machine, and I'm going to be kind of setting it up for a while here. Anyway, it was fun to get this set up. I can't wait to just have this little PC running here and give it some testing for a while, see how it works. And as expected, this cannot compete with a proper gaming PC.